My name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team, and I would like to discuss with you a few tips and tricks to improve your experience using the sketch tool in NX. To begin, we will start with an end cap from a gear motor assembly. As you can see, this is a complex part with a wide variety of cutouts and holes. What we will be working on today is this cutout here on the backside. As you can see, there is just one instance of this cutout. I'm going to open up this sketch and repeat it using the pattern curve tool so our part can become symmetric. As you can see, when I select the pattern curve tool from the top of the screen, a friendly user interface populates in on the left. The pattern curve tool offers plenty of customization options to quickly generate patterns from existing sketches. Notice how quick and smooth the existing sketch can be replicated. Furthermore, users can even control the spacing and frequency at which the pattern is repeated. Also notice the relation finding scope at the bottom of this interface. This can further improve speeds of selecting curves in the part. With the sketch now being completed, we can quickly update the extrude that cuts away from the body of the part in the initial sketch. By utilizing the pattern curve tool in Sketch, productivity can be greatly improved, and it is easy to ensure consistency throughout a part. In just a minute's time, we have been able to take an initial extrude, pattern it in a sketch using the pattern curve tool, and complete our part. Now that we have finished exploring the pattern curve tool, I will open up a new blank model to look at a few other tricks using Sketch in NX. The first thing that I will do is create a circle and a couple of lines. What I'm going to look at is a feature called sketch sliding relations. When two curves have a relation, such as a tangency, there is a dotted line that will extend to demonstrate it. This is very useful in larger, complex sketches, as it is easy to get lost and forgotten. As you can see, no matter where I drag the line, if it is not directly touching the circle, its tangency is illustrated through the dotted line. Additionally, this also works with perpendicular lines. One last tool that is very useful in Sketch can be found when you click and hold on a curve and shake it with your mouse. When this occurs, the constraints on the curve are broken and it is free to move on its own. This allows for quick modification if a constraint was unintentionally applied. In this video, we reviewed the use of the pattern curve tool, sketch sliding relations, and shaking a curve to break constraints in sketches. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.